In this episode, we will take a look at the latest development in my indie game, Too Far Too Late. I will cover the main gameplay loop, which is now complete, the updated moon textures and rocks, some improved animations, and the post-processing effects. I will also talk about the next steps in the game's development, including the addition of survival elements and random events. Welcome to this new devlog of Too Far Too Late, the indie colony game where you build an outpost on the moon and grow your colony. I've dedicated my effort to finish and playtesting the main gameplay loop, mining resources, crafting items, expanding the base, cultivating and gathering crops, and packaging food for the survival of the colony. But that's not all. Some visual improvements have been made. I've updated the moon textures and rocks, reworked the animation script, and added post-processing effects. In this video, I will show all these new features and talk about the next steps toward my goal, making my dream game an entertaining and challenging experience. The main gameplay loop of Too Far Too Late involves the player starting with a lander loaded with construction materials to build a small outpost on the moon. The goal is to expand the outpost and craft more items to survive and grow. To achieve this, the player must explore the surroundings of the lander to find rocks that can be mined to extract ores such as iron, copper, gold, and silicon. The ores can be smelted into ingots that can be transformed into different items to build more structures, walls, roofs, cables, and so on. Once the player has expanded their base enough and crafted the necessary items, they can build a greenhouse with hydroponic machines to grow plants. By planting soybeans, the player can produce more oxygen and food for the colonists. The moon is a fascinating and unique environment that provides a great challenge for a video game about exploration. I wanted to create an experience a bit more immersive that would transport players to the moon's surface. All the terrain textures have been reworked to create a more realistic look. The terrain is generated procedurally and the textures are applied differently to hills and valleys. Also, the rocks that are spawned randomly on the terrain have received a new visual. Before, the rocks had a more low-poly style, but it doesn't fit anymore with the game, so they have been replaced by more realistic rocks and textures. In order to make the characters in Too Far Too Late more dynamic, I've reworked the animation script to create more flexibility in adding and triggering animations. Now, the animation transitions are not configured manually in Unity's animator diagram, but are triggered by the animation script, which removes a lot of unnecessary variables and allows for more flexibility in adding more animations. With these improvements, it's been easy to add more randomness to the character's animation, especially when they're idle. I've been able to add specific animation when the characters take an object or craft something on the crafting table without adding more complexity to the animator diagram. Overall, these changes have made the game's animation smoother and more realistic, adding to the overall immersion of the game. Now, let's talk about the implementation of post-processing in Unity. Post-processing is a technique used in video games to add visual effect to the camera. It's a way to modify the final image before it's displayed on the screen. Unity has a built-in post-processing stack that allows developers to add various post-processing effects to their game, making them more immersive and visually stunning. I will go over the different post-processing effects that have been added to my game to enhance its graphics and showing how the game was before and after each effect. Vignette. It darkens the edges of the screen and creates a spotlight effect in the center, enhancing the immersion and focus on the gameplay. Ambient occlusion. It adds shadows to the corners and crevices of objects and enhances the realism and depth of the environment. Chromatic aberration. It simulates a camera lens distortion and adds color fringes to the edge of objects, creating a futuristic space-like feeling. Bloom. Bloom creates a bright glowing effect around bright objects and lights, which enhances the contrast and gives a dreamy surreal effect. Color grating. It adds more saturation and contrast to the colors, enhancing the visual appeal and giving a more stylized artistic look. Depth of field. I'm using it to blur distant and closed objects depending on the focus of the camera, simulating the effect of the camera lens and creating a better focus on the current action. Auto exposure. By adjusting the brightness and contrast, it creates a dynamic and realistic day-night cycle that enhances the atmosphere and mood of the game. During the night, the auto-exposure simulates the human eye's ability to see better details in low-light environment, making it easier for the player to navigate through the darkness. Overall, the post-processing effects have greatly improved the visual quality of the game, making it a bit more immersive and realistic. The combination of effects enhanced the atmosphere and mood of the game, making the player become more involved in the game environment. As for the next steps, I plan to implement the survival aspect of the game. This includes mechanics such as sleeping, eating, and breathing, which will add a new layer of complexity to the game and will make the player feel more invested in the survival of their colony. I plan to implement event generation in the game, which will add more unpredictability to the gameplay and the story of the colony. Events such as meteors or solar flares will require the player to adapt their strategies and prepare their base accordingly. This will add more unpredictability to the game and will keep the player engaged and challenged. With the implementation of these and other new features, the game will continue to evolve to create a coherent, challenging, and fun experience for the players. And that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed learning about the recent updates to the game and the new features that I'm working on. Remember, if you want to stay up to date with all the latest news, be sure to follow me on Twitter and join my Discord server. I'm always looking for feedback and suggestions from the community, so feel free to share your thoughts. Thank you for watching this video. I see you in the next one.